Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Vinda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Nanda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nanda Nanga Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopi Jano Samayuktam Binda Vanam Manoha वांछा कल्पतरुवश्य कृपा सिंधु व्यवच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयतगिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं वृन्दावै तुलसीदेवै पियावै केशवश्च Shna Bhakti Pade Devi Satta Vattvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottamam Devin Swaraswati Vyasam Tato Jayo Dere Sankirtane Krishna Katho Padesh Gauriya Patrasya Prakasane Chaha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodakcha Jagod Bharanyu Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishchadoham Tithas Padam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam Bhitatiham Panatapal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charanaravindam Yat Pada Pallavanaka Chandamani Chatayam Bispurjita kimapigapavadushvadarsh Purna nuragra sasagra saramurti Saradhikamai kadakipam karush Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Sri Adyaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktabinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Shri Adyaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajanulambita bhujau kanuka bodhato Sankirtanai kavitaru kamala yutakshau Vishambaru dijavaru jugadharma palau Bande jagat priyakaru karuna bataru Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare. Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibha Rupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavan rupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamananga mada puharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishanatham Vagisha Jusho Badane Lakshmi Rajasa Chavakshashi Jasyasthi Hidai Sambhit Pamnishinga Mahambhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare, Hare. Hare. Nikhil bhuvana maya chinna bichinna karti Bibuda bahula meggam mukti mahanta datri Shithirito vidiraga radharadhesha dhani Bilashatu hidinityam bhakti siddhanta bani Nikhila bhuvano maya chinna bichinna karti Bibuda bahula meggam mukti mahanta datri Shithirito vidiraga radharadhesha dhani Bilashatu hidinityam bhakti siddhanta bani Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, keeping in preservation all previous sanskar, anartha, etc., a sadguru never going to initiate anybody. Keeping in preservation all previous anartha and, you know, previous anartha and all problems, any sadguru never going to initiate anybody. This is a system. So diksha, actually I was speaking that day. Actually diksha gim, diksha mean dibhogyan. Three kind of births I already told. One is taking birth from the womb of mother, first birth. Then after taking Savitri, Gayatri, second birth. Third birth when I am initiated by Krishna Mantra, by Sadguru. So, I was discussing that any caste is not at all initiated. In that case, he is actually Shudra. Janmana Jayati Shudra Samaskara Dijo Bhavet. After sanskar, proper sanskar, in the name of sanskar, if something else happening, then I am not responsible for that. Actual sanskar, after actual sanskar, then you can see that everything changing. Sanskara dijo bhavet. So, keeping in preservation all previous problems, anarthas, everything, sinful activities, everything, etc., a sadguru never going to initiate anybody. So even you show those who are big, you know, devotees, they are speaking this way, that if somebody is totally engaged in Krishna bhajan, then automatically he can change his heart, everything can be clean automatically. Actually, we can remember that when Mahaprabhu is speaking to the son-in-law of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, that time Amog, his name was Amog. Amog actually expressing some jealousy, is very bad with Mahaprabhu. After that, when Mahaprabhu going to save him, he was, you know, going to die about. So, he was almost cholera, going to die. Then Mahaprabhu reaching that place and touching the heart of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, touching the heart of that Amog and speaking, Je sahoje nirmal ei brahman hridoy. Sahoje nirmal ei brahman hridoy. Mascha chandal kene iha basaila. Pobitro stan kene apobitro koila. Here one very clear indication. What Mahaprabhu want to say, that usually a pure Brahman, a pure, actual Brahman, his heart is clean, pure. So, why you are going to invite jealousy? Master Chandal, why you are going to invite? It is quite natural that the heart of a Brahman is pure. So, why you are going to invite this, you know, anartha, I mean this jealousy? So you are going to contaminate your heart. So by this indication, what Mahaprabhu wanted to see, wanted to say, that sahaja nirmal ei brahman hidoy, Krishner basati ei yogyasthal hoy. Krishna can sit in a very clean heart. Krishna cannot sit anywhere, dirty heart. Krishner basati ei yogya sthol hoy, masajya chandal kene iha basaila, pavitra sthan kene apavitra kaila. Then I mean Mahaprabhu wanted to say, there is a heart of a Brahman, pure Brahman, is a, you know, clean, very clean, where Krishna can sit. And through Gundicha Manjan Leela, Mahaprabhu also wanted to teach us that if we are not going to clean our heart, then we cannot invite Krishna to sit inside our heart. So long as we are going to get in connection with Anantadev, then we can understand all Siddhanta. So long as we are in connection with Anantadev, then we can understand everything. If you are going to lose our connection, then we can lose everything. We cannot understand even very simple Siddhanta, we cannot understand. So, through this, you know, Leela, Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, usually the heart of Brahman is very clean. So, what is the symptom of Brahman? I already told that day, yesterday, that Gautami Muni wanted to indicate Arjabo Brahmani Shakshat Shudre Anarjava Lakshanam. Arjabo Brahmani Shakshat Shudre Anarjava Lakshanam. Shudro is always, you know, taking help of, you know, falsity. Whereas Brahman is always in favor of, you know, absolute truth, actually, all the time. And also I was speaking about that case of that Nilmadhav discovery. I was speaking about the discovery of Nilmadhav, how Vishabhusu, a name of that Dvaitapati was Vishabhusu, and Vidyapati reached there. On this way I was explaining this point. So the final Siddhanta is that it matters little whether somebody coming from Vaishya family or somebody coming from Shudra family, nothing else. It matters little, because if he is going to do Krishna bhajan, then there is no problem. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sei Guru Hoy. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta, who is going to know, feel this Krishna Tattva Vetta Sei Guru Hoy. Kiva Shudra Kiva Nasi, Kiva Vipra Kiva Nasi Shudra Kena Noy. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sei Guru Hoy. He become Guru, he can act as Guru. But usually it is a standing instruction in Shastra, that Varnanam Brahmano Guru. In all, you know, Vaishya, Shudra, you know, Khatriya, usually it is the rule that Varnanam Brahmano Guru. Out of all Varna, and Brahman is going to act as Guru. But who is Brahman, who is not, so many Siddhanta you are speaking day by day. So actually, point is that Varnanam Brahmano Guru is applicable, but when we can discover a pure Guru Vaishnava, in that case he can act as Guru. That's, there is no doubt in it. So Dvaipa Varnasam system is very scientific, but if we are going to disturb the Dharma, then there is big problem. Also, I was discussing that it is quite impossible to select who is Brahman, who is Vaishya, who is Shudra. It is at present in Kalikal, is very dangerous. But some points are there through which we can try to understand. So, I was speaking yesterday that Sreyanu Sadharma Vigunaha Paradharmat Sanastitat Sadharma Nidhanam Sreyo Paradharma Bhayavaha. Sreyanu Sadharma, if somebody going to follow his own duty according to his, guna and karma, should tally one with. So Sreyanu Sadharma, what is just fitting for him this life, he should follow it. And gradually, you see, if he is going on his duty, doing his duty, gradually he can get benefit in future. But if he is going to break rules and regulation and going to jump to do some other duty which is prescribed for Allah, then it is very dangerous. Then, but this rule is applicable only in this society, samaj. But when about Guru Vaishnava, it is not about Guru Vaishnava, it is not applicable. If we find somebody is initiated by Sadguru, he is trying his hard to do bhajan perfectly. So preliminary stage, there can be some problem, and that's why Prabhupada wanted to give them this kartet to indicate that you should attain minimum qualification, that is Brahmanism. If you can maintain your Shudra Achar, then it is not possible. So anybody initiated by any Sadguru, by Vishnu Mantra, then he can go on practicing this, you know. Then after that, he can go up and up, he can cut all material bondage. In that case, there is no problem, no problem can touch. So this way actually, bonded soul can go. Those who are Nitya Siddha, I am not speaking about them. Bonded soul also, they can go up and up gradually. So they can attain Brahmanism first step. After that, they can attain Vaishnavism. Actually, they can. This way, I was giving example. That in Srimad Bhagavatam, I was giving example from Srimad Bhagavatam, that all the 81 sons of Rishabhdev, actually Rishabhdev, the Bhagavad Amsa coming, but still, actually he is acting as Kshatriya. So all out of 100 sons, 81 sons, they become Brahman. Javiyasam ekasitir jayanteya. Jayanteya means jayanto, wife of Rishabhdev. So javiyasam ekasitir jayanteya pituradeshokara mahasalina mahashotriya Yogya Silaha Karma Vishuddha Brahman Babhuva. They become Brahman. They are expert in Yajna and etiquette, all Acharan, Vedanta, they are knowing everything. This way they become, you know, Brahman. So we can give more and more example. So in Kali Kal, actually, it is really impossible to understand who is Kshatriya, who is, you know. But Prabhupada wanted to set this Daiva Varnasam rule in such a way so that we can understand that who is in what stage. Dibbo Jnanam Jato Dadyat Kuryat Papascha Sankshayam Tasmat Diksheti Sa Prakta Deshi Koi Stattva Ko Vida. So if Dibbo Jnan, the Diksha, this procedure, I was just in the starting I was speaking, preserving all previous anartha, actually all faults of Sisha, Sadguru never going to give initiation to anybody this way. This is not the system. So Diksha means actually Dibbo Jnan. Dibbo Jnan yato dadyat kuryat papasya sankshayam. All his sinful activities, everything, all previous result, all can get vanished. Then after that, Sadguru Kipa, by the mercy of Sadguru Kipa, he can go on doing Guru Seva, he can develop Dibbo Jnan, and through Dibbo Jnan, he can automatically, when Dibbo Jnan is already, Dibbo Jnan Hridaya Prakashito, when Dibbo Jnan already manifested inside heart, then there is no problem at all. And through Diksha, it is written in Hari Bhakti Vilas, that how it is possible that a bonded soul can automatically change his mood, everything. So how possible? Actually, it is possible, it is one kind of reaction take place. And Hari Bhakti Vilas is example given, yatha kanchanatam jati kangsam rasa vidhanataha. Just as if kangsam bell metal, kangsam and jati ejo kanchanatam jati. Kanchanam, it can be converted into gold by the help of some rasayan. Rasayan mani some jatha kanchanatam yati kangsam rasa vidhanataha. In chemistry, some reaction take place between different solutions. So this way, by the help of some solution, this bell metal can get changed into gold. So yatha kanchanatam yati kangsam rasa vidhanataha tada diksha vidhanena dijattam jayate ninam. So this way, a bonded soul, when inclined unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, then Sadguru going to initiate him, so through Diksha and Sanskar, he can change his mood, everything can be changed. This is actually the procedure through which, there is so many argument there actually. So, Shudraha Ashudraha Shudra Kalpahi Brahmanaha Kali Sambhavaha Tesham Agama Margena Sudhir Srauto Batmu Sudhir no Srauto Batmana. In Kalikal, this Sokra Parampara Brahman, if you want to calculate how it is possible through Sokra Parampara, I mean, and genetical factor, birth after birth. This way, actually, you cannot find any purity. You can find only they are all Shudra. So, actually, Pancharatrik Vidhan is effective in this Kalikal. Only through Pancharatrik Vidhan, Mahaprabhu speaking, through this Pancharatrik Vidhan, then through Pancharatrik Vidhan, if somebody is initiated, then it is possible they can change everything. And through Pancharatrik Vidhan, it is the system. After Pancharatrik Vidhan, Diksha is over, then you will have to follow Sadguru. And gradually, you can get everything, all power. Otherwise, not possible. Now, actually, to understand the quality, some instructions are there in Gita, like I already told, the Siyano Sadharma Vigno Sadharma Paradharmat Sanaschitat, Sadharma Nidhanam Sreyo Paradharma Bhayavaho, I was speaking. So, though Sadharma is not good for him, he thinking so, but still, this according to his nature, he can go on doing his own duty at present, and in near future, he can get an advantage. But if he is going to break rules, then no problem. As per Gita, we find that prakete kriyamanani gunai karmani hi avasaha ahankara vimuratma karta aham iti mannate. According to previous sanskar, all jivatma, they are showing their activities, everything, their mood, according to previous sanskar. So actually, all actions are being performed by the moods of prakriti, nature. But those fools, they think we are doing everything. They think that we are doing everything. So in this way, they are inviting their bonded stage. They are going to follow their whimsical mind. They are going to follow their mind. So about Shankar hybriding, I was also speaking yesterday. The Shankar, through Shankar hybrid, if there is mixing and admixing of caste, then there can be a great problem. Purity all can drop, and in women, they become contaminated to give birth to, and any Shudra can marry Brahman can marry Shudra, this way they can get contaminated. So this way there can be big problem. So Sankara, anyway, Sankara Narakayoibho Kulagnanam Kulasacha Patanti Pitorohi Esham Lupto Pindo Dako Kriya. If their heretical factor is not maintained properly, then those their Pitri Purush, their forefathers, they are not going to get their, you know, Shaddat Tarpan. They are not going to get anything, benefit. So anyway, they can get big problem. So this way, Utsanno Kula Dharmana Manussanam Janardano Narake Niyatam Vasa Bhavati Iti Anusasrama. Utsanno, if there is destruction of heretical factor, then there is big problem, and all their forefathers, they can go and, you know, take shelter in hell, no problem. There is no other way. So, kulokshaye pranasanti kula dharma sanatanaha sanatan kula dharma, traditional kula dharma, they can break, and dharmenashte kulan, when total system is destroyed, then adharma can take over, big problem. Now, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, it is the rule in the society, some big personalities, those who are going to follow varnasam dharma, everything, social rules and regulation, according to their activities, those who are important personalities, they are doing. Important in the sense, they are going to follow dharma, social system, everything. So, jat jat acharati sestas tattat deve taro yanaha sajat pramanam kurute lokahas tadanu vartate. Yat jat acharati sestas tattat deve taro yanaha sajat pramanam kurute lokahas tadanu vartate. Krishna Bhagavan speaking that those important personalities, those who are head of the society, so according to their activities, all common people can get inspiration to do. But at present, system, total system is so, you know, breakdown. There is very... So Rabindranath Tagore writing in his one writing, the Amra Sabai Raja Amaderi Raja Rajotte. We are all king in our this country. We are all king. Who is going to rule whom? So this is the problem at present. So point is that the question of Hari Bhajan is totally separate, but general social system should be regulated according to Varnasam Dharma, what Prabhupada wanted to say. General social system, generally, all the social system should be guided, should be controlled by this Daiva Varnasam Dharma. But Hari Bhajan, it is totally different, I told you. Those who are doing Hari Bhajan, what to speak about Brahmanism, they are attending such a high level, we cannot compare with any Brahman. It's impossible. But to general rule is that general rule is that actually, according to their nature, all important personality in the society like Janak Maharaj, Pithu Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, they are all regulated, Ramchandra, they are regulating their life in such a way so that common man, they can also get some, you know, get some inspiration to do accordingly. So, their activities, they are going to help them. This way, they are going to regulate the whole society. But if some question can be there, if we find that somebody in Shudra stage, and if some Maharaj going to speak, well, you come, you are doing a service there, you come and stay in mud. Actually, that Maharaj is not elevated. He is going to take that man, he is going to show that you are very poor. You can come and stay in mud, and you can get prasadam, everything, you can stay very nicely. So he is coming. At present, his stage is not good. At present his stage is, you know, bondage stage. And now I can show you thousands of cases, such. Countless cases. This is the thing happening. That's why so many problem happening in all math mandir. Because those who are going in preaching, that preaching is not perfect maybe. Or those who are going to hear that Harikatha, maybe they are not going to accept. At the same time, the judgment, who can judge, who can pass judgment? In what stage? That so actually it is not the rule that if you are in tamagun, suppose you are shudra, somebody going to teach you, that you can live, you should not do this seva, you go, you come with me, you can start your you can stay in temple. This way, if he is going to guide him, in that case there can be a big problem, because his stage is now not mature. How he can go? So this big problem can be there. So it is written, the Krishna Bhagavan speaking, jed si partha ho Arjun ho partha, at least I have no duty to do, I have nothing to do in this material world, but still I am doing. I have nothing to do in this material world, but still I am doing. Why, you know? Because if I am going to break, I am not going to do anything, then who can follow me properly, and they can go, a wrong way. So Krishna Bhagavan speaking to Partha, na me parthasti kartavyam trishu lokeshu kinchana. In this world, I have no duty at all, but still I am following some duty. Nami parthasti kartavyam trishu lokeshu kinchana nana vyaptam vyaptavyam vatma eva cha karmani. So actually, Arjun, there is no duty at all in all these three worlds for me. Arjun, there is no duty in all the three worlds for me to perform. Nor is there anything worth attaining. I am totally satisfied, because Krishna, totally saturated point there. But still, Krishna like to exchange love affair with new devotees. That is different thing. But actually, Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, is actually saturated point. What to speak about Supreme Lord? Or devotees, those who are elevated devotees, they are always saturated point. Only one point is that I cannot do bhajan properly, I cannot get Krishna prem, that they can speak. This kind of dissatisfaction is good. Like Madhavendra Puripa speaking, na? Ai dindyardhanadi mathuranat kadabalaka shihidam tadaluk kataram hidayam. Tadaluku kataram daita brahmati kim karami aham. But there actually, in front of Gurudev, I mean Madhavendra Puripa, Ramchandra Puri going to advise you. Gurudev, why you are crying? You are actually Brahmavid. Why you are crying? You stop. You should understand. Because Ramchandra Puri think Gurudev is an ignorant, foolish number one. He going to advise. Madhavendra Puripa become very angry. You foolish, go away from me. Eh? I am not going to get Krishna darshan, not Krishna prema, and he is going to advise me. Go elsewhere. I don't like to see your face whole life. Eh? If I see your face, then I have to get some punishment. Eh? Go away from me. So this way, actually, Madhavendra Puripa, when crying, this is called a Vipralamba Bhav. This is saturation is there 100%. No material demand is there. But this is Vipralamba Bhava, high level Vipralamba Bhava, which is expected for all Gauriya devotees finally. So I am speaking about Daiva Varnasam, because without this, so long as we are in bondage stage, we should follow this Daiva Varnasam. So long as we are in bondage stage, we will have to follow this. But when we are going to reach up to certain level, then Daiva Varnasam is not applicable for us. Then in that case, we can understand what Mahaprabhu speaking, naham vipra na charanarapati napi, I already told. This identity we can discover in our life. So, but primarily when we are in, you know, bondage stage, we'll have to follow the Yuvarnasam, otherwise there is big problem. So Arjuna, there is no duty in all the three worlds for me to perform, nor is there anything worth attaining. I have nothing to attain, but still I am doing, yet I am continue to work. I am doing. Why you know? Because if I stop doing any duty, then automatically the whole system can break down. So jodi hi aham na varteyam yatu karma tanditaha, bojen jodi hi aham na varteyam yatu karma matindritaha mamo vatmanu vartante manushvaha partho sarvasaha. Because he is Supreme Lord. In that case, all common men can follow him. So, jodi aham na vartiyam, if I am not going to follow my, if I am not engaged in my action duty, then automatically the whole world can follow me and they can also invite big problem in their society. So, Krishna Bhagavan speaking, just to organize this whole system properly, utsi deshu rime loka na kuryat karma chedaham. If I am not going to do any duty, if I am not going to show any idealism to anybody, then utsi deshu rime loka na kuryat karma chedaham. Sankarasya cha karta swam upahanyami imam prajaha. Then there can be big disturbance in the society. Shankar, you know, admixture of caste and everything can take place, and they can run just negative way. All, you know, system can break down. But because Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, both those who are innocent people, those have no, they have no knowledge. They are in ignorance all the time. They are in ignorance. So, in whatever stage they are at present, you should not disturb them. Now, their, you know, position is very sensitive. If you are going to make them, if you are going to motivate them wrongly, in that case, they are going to lose their own duty. They are going to stop doing their own duty. In that case, they are not eligible to do other duties, and you are not also in a position to help them. You are not Sadguru. In that case, you can. So many cases I know. So many cases. Now he is totally attached in family life. Too much attraction for family life. Now one acharya going, he is, you know, giving him some lucrative offer. Oh, come on, I can make you acharya. I mean, make you, you know, in charge of this temple. I can help you, and you can come in Mutt. Is coming in Mutt. His only son, he is also feeling disturbance, and you know, all system, and wife is also young, all disturbance. This way, from Sudra family, somebody going, if he can deliver one Sudra man, then there is no problem. If he cannot deliver him, because he is not in a, such a position to deliver him, see, in that case, he is going to disturb his own duty, he is going to, no, you should not do it. Better you can come and stay in Mutt. And what can happen? What we can expect? He's coming in Mutt with Sudra behavior, Sudra attitude, and all making problems. So somebody going to misinterpret this position. Somebody, when Prabhupada told, Apnara Sakole Matro Ikwag Dine Jivone, Matro Ikwag Dine Jivone, Bengali Prabhupada speaking, Apnara Sakole Milia Mishya, mutually you all, this life is only for 2 days. All you, mutually should go on doing seva under the same, you know, umbrella of this Acharya Sivad is a, Aki Ashray Vigraho. So, this way, some group going to misinterpret, they are speaking that milya misya men, whatever can be there, you will have to bear. They are going to show me, they are going to, give evidence that Maharaj is written. Prabhupada already told, milya misya, you have to, mutually you will have to do everything. So there can be so many disturbances. Not that. You will have to go back that time when Prabhupada used to maintain. So you should not misinterpret this. Milya misya doesn't mean that one elevated devotee there in the mart, he is going to suffer and you can do whatever you like mlecha and shudra, you can do whatever you like, and that sadhu cannot speak anything to you. You want to mean this, foolish, you want to mean this way. So they can do anything, you have no right to speak. This is called milya misya, mutually. But actually this is not the meaning, what Prabhupada wanted to speak. Milya misya mean actually, those who are coming to mod. You can remember, 2-3 days before I was speaking, one people putting some argument in front of Prabhupada, why not you go to outside to bring all common people from road and, try to give treatment to them. Prabhupada said, okay, at least they should come to me, at least they should say that we are sick, please do a, at least they are the two brahmachari, they are making mistake, but at least they are, thinking that we are actually patient, so treatment, we are undergoing treatment, so at least this kind of situation should be there. So actually, those, common people, they are not going to show submission, what to speak about submission. They are not going to pray in front of Prabhupada that please give treatment to us. So how it is possible? So when you are going to market in the name of preaching, when in the name of preaching you are going to market and bringing all garbage you are bringing, all shudra, kshatri, all disturbing elements, you are going and giving them red cloth, white cloth, everything you are offering them, giving sannyas, everything. So what we can expect? So Prabhupada never wanted to mean that way. Prabhupada never wanted. So milya misya doesn't mean that they can do whatever they like. It is like Saturday club and Sunday club. They can dance with wine and they can do anything. And you will have to keep silence because you are paramahansa. Not that. So it is the advantage. It is the, Prabhupada wanted to say, it is the advantage, it is the great advantage of Goshti Bhajan. It is the great advantage of Goshti Bhajan when we have the scope to meet Prabhupada, when we have the scope to meet, to see Kesava Goswami Maharaj, when we have the scope to see Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj or elevated devotees there. It is our advantage because darshane pavitra kara itamar gun. So in a day, sometime we can get darshan, we can get their uchishta, also harikatha from their lotus mouth. This way, Prabhupada wanted to say that you will have to regulate your life, you will have to check your life, not that you can do whatever you like, not that, you will have to check your life. You will have to get control over your fanciful attitude. So this way actually, Goshti Bhajan is very important, especially in Kali Kal. Especially in Kali Kal, Goshti Bhajan is very, very useful, provided you are going to follow rules and regulations set by Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. If you are not going to allow rules and regulations what set by Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then there can be only you can start Saturday club or Sunday club, nothing else. Kolir club. I speak Kolika. It is the club of Koli. They can sleep up to 8 o'clock. They can sleep up to 7 o'clock. No question of watching Aruti. Because Prasadam is coming from hotel. Gurudev is our servant. Gurudev, anyway, Gurudev giving us Prasadam, everything, cloth, everything, money, everything. And we can also deposit money in bank. This is not the system. Prabhupada never wanted to mean this way. So Prabhupada wanted to give some facility to them in such a way you can go mad. Even you cannot understand why Prabhupada reacting that way. So one or two case I can see. Jat jat acharati sesto tebe taro janaha. So this example I can give one or two example. I like to go back. So then again I can start. So one day actually in one day mother previous home from previous home mother of Bhagavati Ma and very eldest sister. Without any information coming to meet Prabhupada, Vimalapasa Saraswati. Now one Brahmachari was there, two cases I can speak. One I heard from Guru Maharaj, another from another Vaishnava, practical example. Then that sadhu Brahmachari going to leave that room. Prabhupada sitting and doing some job, and the Brahmachari sitting. And in the meantime, without any pre-information, Bhagavati Ma, Bhakti Devi, Bhagavati Ma, what to speak? And very, very old, elder sister, very aged, coming without information, coming to meet Prabhupada, and enter the room without information. Then Brahmachari wanted to leave that room. Then Prabhupada giving indication, you sit here. Then actually, in front of that Brahmachari, they speak something and they gone. After they gone, Prabhupada speaking, you want to make me fall down? You want to make me fall down? So you want to leave this room? So you see the teachings of Prabhupada. Another incident I can say, in Chaitanya Math, very, very, very aged sister, very aged, maybe his age is 60 years. So one day without information, entering the library of Chaitanya Mahat. Prabhupada was doing some seva. Then suddenly Prabhupada shouting, is there nobody? Nobody there? Nobody there? Guru Maharaj Paramananda Bhumaji running there. And so he said, what happens? Then Guru Maharaj entering and you see, elder sister coming to speak something. Then actually, Guru Maharaj could realize, Prabhupada is so careful, that any activities of Prabhupada cannot create any doubt. So it should be the system. In this devotional field, those acharyas, big acharyas, they are sesto. They are actually going to lead us. So their all activities should be regulated in such a way so that we are going to learn from them in each and every step. Without which, if there is no idealism in front of bonded soul, if there is no idealism in front of bonded soul, then how we can, bonded soul cannot get any power to. So it is the main thing. So actually, their life, you know, should be regulated by pure Guru Vaishnava, not that. Actually, there is two kind of acharan. One is actually inside acharan, one is external acharan. External acharan, you see, external acharan is also very carefully we will have to do. I can give two examples. Like when Haridas Thakur do. When Haridas Thakur doing bhajan in Benapol, then without any information that pros, Lakshahira coming in his castle, bhajan kutir. In that case, Haridas Thakur wanted to deliver her. But be careful, if Prabhupada is there in place of Haridas Thakur, surely Prabhupada acting as big acharya. So in that case, Prabhupada, you know, it was not possible for that lady to stay there. Haridas Thakur is exceptional personality. Haridas Thakur Namacharya. He wanted to show one remarkable example in front of us. It is very important thing that Prabhupada actually wanted to give example one by one, very important example. So Haridas Thakur wanted to wanted to, you know, show some remarkable example in front of us, but usually it is not possible. If we are alone, I can say another example I can speak and go back to my original topics. One day, actually, one of the disciple of Prabhupada, I mean lady disciple, Shisha, wanted to speak something to Prabhupada lonely. One day, she is seeking permission from Prabhupada. I like to speak you something very personally. I cannot speak in front of everybody. Prabhupada speaking, no. Whatever you like to speak, you will like to speak in front of everybody. I cannot allow you this kind of opportunity. So this way, each and every step, in each and every step, we can discover this kind of gigantic personality. The Prabhupada and his unique acharyaship. So this way, you see, Prabhupada wanted to show is very important, so all of us will have to follow this point. So what I mean to say, in the name of Milia Mishya, if you want to set one agenda, Maharaj, from today onward we can do everything, you know, mutually, so we should not find any, you know, we should not find any faults with each other. Oh Maharaj, you cannot, you ask me, what do you mean to say? Bonded soul can never find any of his own faults. Bonded soul can never find any fault with himself or herself. Bonded soul can only find fault with others. But when pure Guru Vaishnava is going to find fault with me, then obviously he is going to help me to come up in bhajan. That doesn't mean he is going to criticize me. He is going to find some fault and is going to insult me. I should not think that way. I should not think that way. So, this is not the system. One example I can give. So, if one brahmachari for long time doing bhajan in archan, in Chaitanya Mat, doing archan, Prabhupada can realize everything. What Prabhupada cannot understand? That brahmachari day by day, due to bad association, asasanga, he is going down and down. Prabhupada could realize. Prabhupada wanted to help him, but he was kapat. He was kapat. So, how Prabhupada can? If somebody going to maintain his kapat behavior, then we have no way to help him to come out of this danger, maya. No way. So, one day Prabhupada doing bhajan, in his bhajan kutir in Chaitanya Mat, in Chaitanya Mat, you know, bhajan kutir. And one day in the morning time, actually, around 4:30, Prabhupada, Bhakti Vijay Bhavan. The bhajan kutir of Prabhupada is Bhakti Vijay Bhavan. From there, Prabhupada, 4:30, running towards Govinda Mandir, Chaitanya Mat, Deity Mandir. And going to enter into the temple and going to push the deity of Gauranga Mahaprabhu and getting so many love letters. So many love letters. And the pujari was so, you know, afraid. Pujari couldn't realize what is this. Prabhupada coming and straightway giving some pressure on the deities of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, and from down, I mean, from the left footsteps, Prabhupada getting so many letters, love letters. And immediately Prabhupada speaking to him, you out from here. Immediately you out. So Prabhupada cannot allow kapat behavior. Prabhupada can help us. If we are weak enough, we are so weak, we cannot go ahead in bhajan. Repeatedly we are going to make some mistake. But that day I was explaining, Opichet sudra acharo bhajate mamanna bhag sadureva samantabva sammag vyavasito hisha. Now his brain is well organized. He is not going to take help. He is not going to take help of any demigods. He is not going to take help of yoga procedure, jnana procedure, or any, you know, nothing. His mind is now totally settled down. He understands that Krishna bhajan is the only solution. But he is so weak, day by day, he is making mistake. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that can be excused. That can be excused because elevated sadhu, they can help him to come up. But that doesn't mean, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that doesn't mean that purposely somebody can go on doing mistake, purposely. He can go on doing mistake and he can show that Opichet Sudracharya residence, so why you are going to beat me? Why are you going to chide me? This you cannot speak. So this way actually big problem. Opichet Sudracharya with the help of this sloka, some sannyasi, some brahmachari can do all rubbish and they want to prove that it is written in Gita. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti never wanted to speak that way. So at all, if our brain is well organized, we are sure about this point, we are 100%, you know, we have 100% faith that Krishna bhajan can give all solution, but at present I am weak. So for weak people, Prabhupada is going to help. It is so many cases there. So weak, weak, you know, I cannot do anything, making mistake. So Prabhupada can help them. Like the case of Ajamil, I can give example of Ajamil. Ajamil actually Brahman. But so what? Why I can say that Ajamil was Brahman? That the characteristics there was, he is very plain-hearted, very simple. He used to worship Salagram. He used to pay respect to all elderly personality, all, everything. All, character, everything, like Brahman. But with bad association, day by day, he fall down, he becomes Shudra, more than Shudra. So not that I can attain Brahman stage, I cannot fall down any day, not that. I can come in Hari Bhajan, so I have mala from Gurudev, I have my, you know, mala in my, you know, Kanthi mala and pit back, so nobody can point out my fault, so I am actually not Shudra. I am actually a devotee, this I cannot say. Countless such example you can say, with the help of beadback, you know, japamala, with the help of this kantimala, tilak, we can do whatever we like. That is why Bhaktivinoda Thakur was bound to write one article in which he wanted to point out, devotees, we must be very careful because most of us, we are going to take initiation from so-called Gurudev. We are also going to follow, Ekadasi, etc. We are also going to follow, Sandhavan and everything. We are acting that way. But nobody is going to calculate how much improvement we are making. That they are less interested. Now, due to lockout, they have enough time to do 1 lakh Harinam, but they say, Maharaj, well, we cannot do 1 lakh. What you are doing then? Eh? 1 lakh Harinam you cannot do now? Enough time is there? You have time for sleeping, eating, everything, but you cannot find. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, well, and oh devotees, most of us, we are going to take initiation. I mean, at least we are acting to take initiation from some Guru Acharya, and also we are going to follow all Ekadashi Vrata, etc. Vaishnava Vrata also, Tilak Mala, everything, red cloth, blue cloth, green cloth, or whatever we like, we can take, because it is we are, and sannyas cloth, you can take. After that, we are not going to calculate, we are not going to think over and again. So what improvement I have done in my life with this cloth? Nobody going to? So because Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they are making disturbance, they are making aparad unto the lotus feet of Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Nam, Dam at a time. So many aparad. We are knowingly, unknowingly, we are going to make aparad unto the lotus feet of Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Dam, Nam, all the time. We are making aparad. That's why, due to aparad, we cannot make any improvement in your bhajan. and due to aparad we can grow, we can fall down in consciousness, our consciousness can drop due to aparad. How you can know? Today, previously you wanted to do bhajan, but now you cannot do. Then you should realize that there is aparad. So if there is aparad, automatically you cannot feel any inspiration to do bhajan. Not only that, but also your consciousness can drop. Day by day, your consciousness can drop down. So you can then understand that there is big aparad. So everybody want to show that we have taken initiation from this guru, that guru, red clothes or sannyas, this is not the judgment. It is written in Shastra, Jai bhaja sei baro, abhakta hinchar. Jai bhaja sei baro, who is doing bhajan? Bhaktivinoda Thakur in one article writing, suppose Grihastha Bhakta doing nice bhajan, his character is so nice, then maybe I am sannyasi, I am actually fallen sannyasi. Then externally nobody can understand. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Prabhupada speaking, then if Grihastha doing big bhajan like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, nobody could realize what kind of great sadhu Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In Grihastha Asamba, all the time doing bhajan. So, jai bhaja sei varo abhakta hinchar, Krishna bhajane nahi jatkuladi vichar. So, abhakta, those who are not going to do bhajan, only going to take some advantage of initiation from Gauriyamad, going to take advantage of red cloth, sannyas, then there is big mismanagement in the society. So I can go back to the case. Goshti bhajan is really helpful. Goshti bhajan is so helpful that I can show that how Prabhupada used to regulate Goshti bhajan, Ishta Goshti, everything, and all rules and regulations, strict rules and regulation. So somebody must be there in this mutt who is going to take care of all devotees. Not that they can do anything, I can lock my room and sit inside and do Harinam. Then what is the utility of Goshti bhajan? Goshti bhajan means or elevated devotee, they can teach us, they can give us instruction, they can try to regulate our life. Then we can gradually go on hearing his order. We can carry out his order. We are going to hear his harikatha, and day by day we can make some improvement in our bhajan. So Goshti bhajan, this is because in a Gauriyamath there is two elevated devotees. So two elevated, maybe there is 25 bonded soul, maybe in red cloth, white cloth, maybe. Then they are going to regulate the soul system. In that case, actually, it is possible that through Goshti bhajan, they are going to take their darshan, they are going to put some question, get some solution, going to take Mahaprasadam, and their Harikatha they are going to. This way, Goshti bhajan can help you. If Goshti bhajan is going on at present, there is nobody. Only you are going to open one hospital. In this hospital, you are going to bring all different kind of, patient. And there is no doctor. If you are going to bring all patient from different place, and you are going to admit them in Gauriya hospital, and there is no, doctor, no medicine, in that case, what can happen? This is the same position where people can become angry with me. But 100% what I am speaking, 100% true. They are not making all manipulation, everything. When the situation is totally out of control, they want to invite me, Maharaj, you come and help me. What I can help? When I am telling from 20 years back, for 20 years, Maharaj, you will have to follow this and rules and regulation. Then you can get control over the situation. You can make an exact Gauriyamath you can write. Ah, he is laughing like a mad people speaking in Toronto. Now, come on, you are speaking me. What I can do? Now, when situation totally out of everybody, you can go. Then, out of control, what to do? In that case, situation out of control. So if you are going to invite, or this is the same situation, never mind, excuse me, never mind. In all society are going to invite all bonded soul, admission going on, and there is somebody having malaria, somebody having cholera, somebody having typhoid, somebody having some other disease, and they are all staying in same place. And what to speak about corona disease? One person should maintain distance 1 kilometer. Maharaj. So now they are all staying with each other. The corona disease, they are going to spread corona disease among them. So all corona disease, corona patient, and there is no doctor. This is the situation at present. I am not making any story. You go and find the situation, same. So Matmin, that is why Prabhupada wanted to speak very clearly. I wanted to make 50 living Gauriamat. I wanted to make 50 living Gauriamat. See, though living Gauriamat, they can go here and there, they can speak Harikatha, their acharan should be glowing, very nice acharan. The same thing I am speaking now. Yad jad acharati sestas stattva devi taro yanaha sajat pramanam kurute lokahas tadano vartate. So common people can follow them. So that is why this is a mismanagement at present, and there is no such a big leader. And nobody, we are actually, I already told, we are all king in our kingdom. Who is going to follow whom? If you find some very nice elevated personality, but there is one disease, that is politics. You know that Bamun Maharaj, Bamun Goswami Maharaj is elevated. But I am feeling, how I can obey him? I have some politics. This way actually, all over the world, there is some disease. He cannot tolerate him, he cannot tolerate him. She is going to tolerate, he is not going to tolerate him. This way all mismanagement happening, this way all. So, and not only that, but also, suppose previously when you came in Mutt, then only one disease was there with you. That is actually cholera. So treatment was supposed to be done. But now you are staying with one, you know, malaria devotee. So now, within 2-3 days, you are developing both, you know, cholera disease only one disease. Now you are going to get another disease together with that. That is cholera and malaria. And then malaria patient, he is going to take cholera also. This way, contamination going on, so there is no way out. There is no such a super personality who can control, who is going to obey him. This is all mismanagement all over the world. I am maintaining brahmacharya, also I am mixing with women. Oh, Maharaj, one night, no problem. One night, no problem. Sannyasi is speaking, one night, no problem. Okay. One brahmachari, sannyasi, they are speaking this way. So this way, this is their procedure, they are maintaining. So how we can expect they can get power in bhajan? It is not a matter of joke. It is not a matter of joke that in the name of Hari Bhajan I can bring you, you can start business. Very nice business you can do. With this white cloth or red cloth, you can start business. So, the first instruction, please try to understand. Prabhupada never wanted to throw anybody who is feeling weak. But provided who is going to say, I am weak, Prabhupada, please save me. So many examples I told already. Actually, Prabhupada can help. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Bhargo can help us, provided we are Niskapat. But Niskapat Bhava is not there, then who can help whom? Guru Bhargo like to help, but who can accept? This way, the first point is that, in the name of Daiva Varnasram, we cannot allow all rubbish to go away. Go on. We cannot allow all rubbish thing to go on in the name of Daiva Varnasam. Not that. So in that case, our system can break down. So now Krishna Bhagavan is speaking to Arjun. Arjun, see, if I am not going to follow my duty, because all people going to follow me, Because he is anyway his Supreme Lord. And sarva karana karanam, if Krishna Bhagavan not going to follow, then whole system can break down. So utsi desu rime lokaha na kuryat karma chedaham. If I am not going to follow my own duty, then I would become responsible for the total destruction of this society. But one example I was speaking, suppose you are going for preaching. What is the system of preaching? You will have to keep in mind this Daivo Varnasam Dharma system. You will have to keep in mind all the time, a scientific system. So when you are going in preaching field, I can take it as granted that you are actually a Prakita Brahman. Otherwise, why you are going to for preaching? You are a Prakita Brahman. You are already attending. Not only that, Madhyam Adhikari should be there. Madhyam Adhikari, without Madhyam Adhikari, nobody should go for preaching. Bonded soul, if going for preaching, they are going to take the test of, this material, Rupa Rasa, Shabda Sparsa, Rupa Rasa Gandha. Bonded soul, when going outside, when staying inside mat, they are all sense organ, always very active. Tongue always like to get nice food. Eyes like to search some ugly picture. Ear, like to hear some ugly thing. So I was giving the example of, Ajamil. Ajamil was Brahman. It is written in Bhagavatam. But Ajamil become fall down. Ajamil was Brahmin actually. He was maintaining his life properly, but due to asasanga, because Kipa karo prabhu diya chit bol. In kirtan we find Kipa karo prabhu diya chit bol. Mean chit bol mean chit potency, chit power. So chit bol where from we can get? Ekaki amar nahi pae bol harinam sankirtane. What do you mean? Same thing. Sadhu Sangha. So Sadhu Sangha, by Sadhu Sangha I can get power. So without Sadhu Sangha, how I can? So Ajamil was that much power was not. That much chitbal was not there with Ajamil. So that chitbal can save Ajamil. That is why it was not sufficient, insufficient. So, in course of time, asasanga, he fall down. So, day by day, Haribhajan means you will have to do every fraction of second. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur praying unto a lotus feet of Supreme Lord, Vaishnava Vishas Vidhi Ho Khane Khane. Oh Prabhu, you please bless me so that I can increase my faith in Guru Vaishnava every fraction of second. So you now, by now you understand the total bhajan rahasya, all the secrecy of our bhajan resting on this single point, that how much satsanga you are going to get, how much satsanga you are going to get, how much power, chit potency you are going to get. Be careful, in the name of satsanga, if you are going to get asasanga, it's dangerous. In the name of satsanga, if you are going to get asasanga, then I am not responsible. Also, if we are going to do satsanga, it is one kind of exhibition on your part. You like to show that you are doing satsanga, but actually you are not going to accept all the siddhanta vichar etiquette in your life. In that case, that satsanga is not effective in your life. Even Rupa Goswami was speaking, be careful. One example I can give. Rupa Goswami was speaking, if somebody coming to Gauriya Math for 20 years, if somebody coming in Gauriya Math for 20 years, in his locality, maybe it is in locality that Gauriya Math is there, he is coming for past 20 years. But actually, Rupa Goswami was speaking, until and unless he is going to take shelter of a Sadguru, we cannot say that he is doing satsanga. For 20 years, past 20 years he is doing satsanga, but he is not feeling any urgency. He is not feeling any urgency to take shelter unto lotus feet of Sadguru. Rupa Goswami is speaking, this is not actually satsanga. Ado Guru Pada Sraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. Okay. So this way, actually, at all, if you are going to feel any inspiration to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, shelter means shelter. Not that in the name of shelter you are not going to show submission. In that case, Dikha, this procedure, is not successful. So shelter means shelter. So actually, if somebody coming to Gauriya Math for past 20 years, but still he is not feeling any inspiration to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, then be sure he is kapat. He is not going to do satsanga. Be careful. For simply for social status and glamour, he is going to join Gauriya Math sometime, giving some donation, this, that. I can give one example. One rich man actually is Marwari, I think. That time, long ago, in Gauriya Math, he used to come. Daily morning time, after Aruti is over, after Aruti, non-morning time, it is not possible for him to get up early in the morning. So maybe 7:30 is coming daily and paying Dandavat and one Parikama maybe. After that, giving some donation so that he can maintain his business very nicely. So first of all, he is going condition, Krishna, I am giving some donation to you. Be careful. You will have to give business nice. This is our seva. Somebody going to give Paramanna to Nishingadev. 20 kg Paramanna. You can remember Nishingadev. Last month I provide 20 kgs per manna. See, you are not taking care of my case. Now some income tax people coming and putting me in trouble. What use? This is our seva. Bhagavad seva, Guru Vaishnav seva. So, this is our actually seva. We are Guru Varga making joking with us. This is our style of seva. Actually, we are those who are in the north part, especially in north part of India, it is this kind of thing, is, you know, this kind of song going on. This kind of song going on. And what is this? Mane, actually, they are singing that all the disease and every problems, all problems can go away and you will have to do kipa. They are praying daily in front of Shivji Maharaj, or in front of Ganesh ji, they are always praying this way. So this is their seva actually. So that rich man, that Mavari, every day coming and paying dandavat for a long time, but he is not feeling any inspiration to take shelter onto the lotus feet of Sadguru. Yes, one kind of status, you know, maintain and some glamour he can get. Oh, he is bhakta going to. So one actually every day he is coming and praying in front of, so after paying dandavat, he is praying in mana papo ham papas karmanam papas supapa sambhavaha trahi mam pundarikaksha sarva papa haro hari. Every day, you see, kapat. Every day he is praying, Prabhu, my whole feature is pap. My total feature is sinful feature. Papa aham, papas karmanam. I am doing all sinful activities all the time. So, Prabhu, I have no respite. Please excuse me. Please save me. Papa aham, papas karmanam, papas su papas sambhavaha. Trahi mam. This way always he is praying. So one day, one brahmachari thinking, maybe he is kapat. Every day speaking papam papas karmanam papas svapa sambhavaha trahimam punarigaksha sarva papa haro hari. Please try to deliver from this sinful, you know, ocean. Please, this way, every day praying. So one brahmachari wanted to test whether he is speaking from heart or simply this one kind of, you know, exhibition. So one day that brahmachari calling, when he is paying dandavat and after the prayer is over, that Marwadi, I mean rich man, going away from the temple. And that Brahmachari asking, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So actually, that Brahmachari calling, that calling this way, so he was very angry. He was giving answer, you should be, actually, you have no etiquette. Why you are calling this way? The Brahmachari is speaking, excuse me, actually you are going to identify yourself in terms of Supreme Lord. So what I can do? So, then the man could realize that I am kapat, that Brahmachari arrest me. Yes, I am kapat. So usually in North India you can go here and there you can find, morning time all Matajis they are running with one pot, you know. There is some chamber, small. In one, some raw rice, some paddy, some this, that, all running in the morning. To offer to Ganeshji, Shivji, all different, countless, you know, deities they are going. And their prayer, what kind of prayer they are putting? But actually, Sukha Sampatti Aye Gharka. Sukha Sampatti Aye Gharka. Kashtamite tanka. So they are praying this way. All different kind of material benefit we can get, and all my disease can disappear. Sukha sampatti aye ghare. You know, this way they are praying. Kashtamite tanka. If any there is any disease or any problem in body, oh Prabhu, please try to help me. This is their prayer. So this way all we are kapat, most of them. So now actually this is not actually Hari Bhajan. So what Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak, that we are taking the base of everything, externally everything okay. My red cloth, the sannyas, oh everything okay. I am doing japa. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur is thinking, speaking, they are not going to think over and again if there is any aparad or not. If there is aparad, then they cannot do Hari Bhajan. They cannot do Hari Bhajan because the consciousness can drop down. Drop down. This is a big problem. So Rupa Goswami Pada, I was giving the example. If somebody coming in Gaudiya Math for the past 20 years, but still today he is not feeling any inspiration to take shelter of Sadguru, then surely it is not at all satsanga. Satsanga means as soon as you are doing satsanga, satsanga has some reaction inside your heart. So satsanga can help you to increase your consciousness. You can feel it very urgent to take shelter of Sadguru, to start Hari Bhajan. If somebody doing satsanga from this material world, surely it means improvement can be there. He can feel it necessary gradually. So that kind of Harikatha if is there, if some fallen soul is there, maybe his duty, now he is actually Vaishya, doing some business. If suppose he is going to meet with some real sadhu, in that case he is going to hear Harikatha and totally change his life. Totally he is going to develop detachment. In that case actually, he is praying unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada or you know Sadguru, please save me, please help me. I like to do Hari Bhajan. This kind of submission should be there. In that case, maybe he was, you know, as per Daiva Varnasam, you can find that he is now at present after Diksha, after doing Bhajan, he is attaining, you know, actually Aprakita Brahmanatta. He is going to attain Paramarthik Brahmanatta. And if we go on doing bhajan gradually, then all problem can be finished. So now what some point I like to discuss today, time is limited. So one advice Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving, that no buddhi vedam janayed ajnanam karma sanginam joyayet sarva karmani vidvan yukto samacharan. Actually, Bhagavan speaking, a wise man who is very gyani, he should not disturb the balance of the society. He should not speak all rubbish. That you are Sudra sweeping, oh, let us do, let us go and go to temple and we can worship, start worshipping. So we should not speak this way. We should not, you know, inject some poison inside your mind. So through Harikatha, if you can change, then it is possible. I already told that those of pros, Haridas Thakur in front of pros went on doing Harinam, has totally changed. That kind of power was there with Hari, was with Haridas Thakur. So he was doing bhajan in front of that pros, and day by day he changed his mood. So it was possible for Haridas Thakur. Maybe it is not possible for somebody. So according to power, we will have to, you know, do. So no buddhi vedam janayad ajnanam karma sanginam. Suppose somebody having a strong attachment for family life, he is a strong attachment for his business, and some sadhu reaching, so-called sadhu, going to speak all rubbish. Ah, it's bad, you see, you will have to do this. No, no, not that way. That way, if you are going to do, then there is a big problem can be there. So, very slowly you will have to give medicine. If you are going to approach in a very, random way, then it can give you a bad result. Even he can lose his minimum faith in you. So many cases I can show you here. So, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Na buddhi vedam janayed ajnanam karma sanginam. Those who are having attachment with this material life, family life, this, that, you should not go and give high dose. You should not go and give high dose and break their system of mind. So, Na buddhi vedam janayed ajnanam karma sanginam. Josheyat sarva karmani vidyan yuktaha samacharan. A wise man established in his self should not disturb the mind of ignorant attached to action. His different kind of activities, social service, these, they are attached. If you go and try to fight with him on this ground, you can lose all everything. This is not good. So you see, but should not get them to perform all their duties, but should get them to perform all these duties regularly in a very systematic way. Rather, you can give some medicine in such a way that he can maintain his faith. Maharaj, you are doing business? No, no, no. Oh, no problem, you are doing business, okay. But you will have to think, nah? After some day you will have to leave your body. So better you can do, give some water in Tulsi, yeah? You go and take bath in Ganga, this you can do, minimum. This way, gradually, day by day, he can increase his faith. After that, okay, Maharaj, you have no time. But please hear this Harikatha, please. 5 minutes, 10 minutes you hear. This way, gradually if they go on, doing this kind of activities under the guidance of a proper wise man. Wise man never like to disturb them because their base is very green, unstable stage. They are now on unstable stage. If you go and break the stage, they can fall down on ground. It's not good. So a wise man established in self should not disturb the mind of ignorant attached to action, who is having attraction for different kind of activities. Let them do, but try to regulate their activities in a moderate way, but should not get them, but should get them to perform all those duties in a very regulated way. In that case, gradually you can find some solution. He can grow some soft mood. Today or tomorrow he can grow some soft mood. And finally you can invite him. That was the system. That's why Prabhupada used to invite them. Prabhupada used to say, we will have to give prasadam to them. We'll have to give prasadam to them. Now at present prasadam, if we can offer, if we can make prasadam, If we have at all that kind of power, that I can cook, I am doing one lakh harinam, I am maintaining purity, I am going to maintain one lakh harinam, I am going to offer to Krishna out of my love, Krishna going to accept it, Krishna not going to reject. Patram, patram, puspam, phalam, toyam, jome bhakta prajachati. You should discuss this sloka. So Krishna can accept everything, but provided you are giving out of your own love, dedication, fix, affection. So in that case, it is written, patram, puspam, phalam, toyam, jome bhakta prajachati. Out of strong devotion, if somebody is going to offer something to Krishna, Krishna 100% going to take it. There is no doubt. So Vishwanath Chakravarti is giving nice commentary on this, on this sloka, that patram, oh Maharaj, what you are speaking? Patram means leaf, different kind of leaf, leaf, patram pushpam. And what Krishna can, patram pushpam phalam toyam jome bhakta paichati, taram asmami, asmami I am eating. And patra, or leaves also, Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, yes. Krishna, when somebody is going to offer something, out of tremendous love, even he lost his consciousness at present, material consciousness. He is going deep into his feeling. He is going to offer something. He forget. Like, I can give the example of Bidurani, Bidu, wife of Biduji Maharaj, giving skin of banana to Krishna. You can remember. I'm giving this example. Krishna was there inside the palace of Duryodhan. Duryodhan requesting him to take prasadam here. Krishna said, I have no appetite. I'm not feeling hungry. I cannot take. So a little bit, no, actually, I should not. Then that Krishna, when reaching, just a few minutes after when reaching the house of Bidurji Maharaj, after opening the door, then Bidurji, wife of Bidurji, discovered Krishna coming. But Bidurji Maharaj was not there that time. He gone from Madhukuri. So now Krishna is saying, I'm very hungry. Actually, after Madhukuri, Bidurji Maharaj and my husband can come. Yeah. No, I cannot wait. I am very hungry. You give me something. Then what to do? The wife of Bidurji Maharaj, Bidurani, discovered that some ripe banana is there. Better, why not I offer this banana to Krishna? Okay. In front of Krishna, Bidurani is sitting and giving skin to Krishna, looking at his lotus mouth, just like hypnotized, and offering skin and throwing the banana. In the meanwhile, when Biduji Maharaj entering the house, he discovered Krishna come here, is dancing. Oh my God, what you are doing? You are giving skin to Krishna? You are throwing banana? Foolish? Krishna laughing. I am not taking banana. I am not taking skin. I am taking only love. So this is the Vishwanath Chakravarti was also explaining this way. Actually, out of tremendous love, if somebody is going to offer something, because maybe he is in deep ecstasy, he forget what he is offering. In that case, ipatram puspam phalam toyam. Toyam in water, anything, puspam in flower. Krishna without argument going to eat it. But this is the love of Krishna. So this way, if we can at all make a prasadam, in that case, we can offer prasadam to other. In the name of prasadam, if I am interested to arrange big bandara, and they are mainly menu, chana rasa, puspanna, paramana sweet ball, what all different kind of items. This is the predominating factor. In that case, big problem. That's why in Jagannath Mandir, 100% Jagannath has commitment. 100% Jagannath going to take. Because they are Lakshmi ji cooking. So in every temple, we cannot give guarantee. Not that. only big exalted, you know, those sadhus. I can give so many examples from the life of Prabhupada, life and teachings of Prabhupada. I can show how it was possible for Prabhupada to offer, and how it was, you know, it was possible for Gauranga Mahaprabhu to accept. I can show all different kind of example. So no buddhi bhedam janayed ajnanam karma sanginam yojayet sarva karmani vidyan yukto samacharan. So actually you should follow a very moderate procedure through which you can bring some change in the life of that materially attached people, material people. So you go on giving some honor to him also. Like Prabhupada used to say, tomorrow I can discuss. If we are going to give some honor to somebody, if this honor going to help us in our bhajan, then what wrong in it? So what is the mystery of this world? The Prabhupada and his unique acharyaship, I can go on discussing. Now with one example I like to finish today. Due to disturbance, I am feeling very sorry. So you see, I can give one example, like Janak Maharaj. Janak Maharaj, Pithu Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, Ramchandra, you can go through their life, you can find Ambarish Maharaj practicing nine folds of bhakti, Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Svaram, all different. And somebody can follow one bhakti like Parikshit Maharaj. Sivishnu Svane Parikshit Ababad Bhayasaki Kirtane. Bhayasaki Kirtane means Parikshit Maharaj was successful in Sravan procedure of bhakti. And Sukhdev Goswami wanted to prove that Kirtan. So this way, one by one, we have nine different acharyas. Those who are going to show, some of them going to follow one mode of bhajan, somebody going to two, somebody three, somebody nine, like Parikshitma, nine at a time. Anyway, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, ekongo sadhe kimba sadhe bahu ango, nishtha hoite upajay premetvarango. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Charitamrita speaking, ekongo sadhe kimba sadhe bahu ango. Maybe somebody going to follow one mode of bhajan, not nine fold of bhajan at a time. Nine fold is minimum 64 different kind of modes of bhajan, but main nine. Out of them also Mahaprabhu making five in gist. So this one fold of bhajan, if you are going to follow perfectly, it can also give you success. Maybe two, maybe three, and Ambarish Maharaj is going to voice nine at a time. So it not a matter. So it depends upon how much nishtha you have. If you have no nishtha, nothing, it is one kind of exhibition, then how we can expect you can come out successful? So Janakadi, big, you know, acharya, they are actually big acharya. Janakji Maharaj was the advisor of Sukhdev Goswami. Now think of it. Big Manirishi coming in front of Janakji Maharaj to get some advice from him. Now think of it. What is the gravity? So Varnasam, Daiva Varnasam Dharma, Daiva Varnasam Dharma is so sensitive, so sensitive. Through some example, also next day we can try to discuss. So today we are bound to stop here because time cannot permit. So we'll have to stop here. So Nikhilo Bhubana Maya Chinna Vichinna Karti Vibhuda Bahulo Mrigyam Mukti Mahanto Datri Shithilito Vidiraga Radho Radeshadani Bilasati Hidunityam Bhakti Siddhantobani Vancha Kalpataru Vashyaki Pasindhi Bhavisho Patitanam Pavani Bhavishna Bhyonam Tamadi Devam Purusho Puranam Tamalavarnam Suhitavataram अपार संसार समुद्र से तुम भजामहे भगवतो स्वरूपम यं ब्रवयन्न मनपेतमपेत कृत्वं दैपायन विरहका तर्वाजुहाव पुत्रेति तनमयतया तर्वो विनेधु त्वं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानसोऽस्मि नारायणं नरस् नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जय मुजीरहे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे